people know green iguanas because they're some of the most commonly kept pet reptiles, but there's a lot more to them than hanging out in home terrariums. Naturally, green iguanas are from southern Mexico to northern South America. They live in forests high up in the tree canopy, where they can stay away from predators and enjoy the rays of the sun. Green iguanas are ectothermic, meaning they depend on the surrounding environment to determine their body temperature. This has actually caused a problem for non-native green iguanas living in Florida. As an invasive species, green iguanas are not completely adapted to the environment of the habitats in which they don't naturally occur. When it gets too cold in Florida, it will literally start raining green iguanas. If they get too cold, they enter a state of low activity in which they're unable to move much. The green iguanas are still alive, but they can't very well hold on to their tree perch, and so they just plop right out of the tree. Man, weird things happen with invasive species. In their natural habitat, green iguanas have a hierarchy of older adults living higher in the trees than younger juveniles. These prime spots in the treetops are perfect for getting as much sun as possible and digesting meals. And they can be a source of controversy in the green iguana community. Green iguanas will actually fight one another for the best basking spot, though generally nobody gets hurt too bad. That's because green iguanas are smart in how they choose their trees. They might not seem it, but green iguanas are fantastic swimmers, and they will purposefully choose trees that are close to waterways so they can drop down for an easy getaway if any sort of threat appears. It should also be noted, too, that they can drop down to solid ground from as high as 40 feet off the ground without getting hurt. They ain't robust for nothing. Green iguanas can weigh more than 15 pounds, though they're usually closer to half that. Including their tail, they can be well over 6 feet long. Those long tails are handy for defense as well, as they can be used as a whip to ward off enemies, or can be completely dropped, leaving anyone holding the opposite end in a bit of a stupor. Younger individuals have to watch out for birds of prey, but adult green iguanas don't really face many predators besides humans. Humans capture green iguanas for the pet trade and to use their skin for leather, and also, they eat them. There's even an iguana cookbook. Technically, green iguanas aren't classified as a threatened species. However, they are monitored in terms of trade as their populations have suffered declines from human persecution. That just makes the idea that a government is actually paying people to hunt green iguanas all the more crazy to consider. Though, the green iguana is invasive there. When they can avoid humans, green iguanas may live to be as old as 20. They begin life in an egg, unprotected by their mothers. After hatching, it can be anywhere from 2 to 5 years before they're ready to produce babies of their own. Females sometimes return to the same nesting spot year after year, and they'll even share sites if there's limited availability. And, believe it or not, green iguanas aren't always green. In fact, they can change color just depending on the time of day, time of year, and surrounding temperature. So if you see an orange iguana, it's probably still